Audits? That does not sound like a fun topic, but when you do a Facebook ad audit, you can find some hidden gems to help you improve your results and some underperforming ads that you can stop spending money on. In this video, I'm going to be covering how to look at the big picture analysis of your ad account so that you can find the trends for your audiences, your creatives, and your placements to help you get better results. We'll dive deeper into each campaign so that you can really spot what's working and what's not working. And stick around to the end because I'm gonna show you a hidden feature to give you some really exciting data that you probably haven't seen before. The first section is the overview section of your ads manager. To get there, you'll click on the little clock icon that is on the left side of your ads manager screen. When you get in there, you can switch your view from the drop-down list to see different things such as reach, leads, or purchases, and now you can see which demographics are responding best to your ads overall. For example, you can see which gender or age range or country is really responding. And then you can make better decisions on who you want to show your ads to in the future. Another great part of the overview section is the creative reporting. You can click on creative reporting and see which images have performed best over a period of time. It defaults to lifetime view, but I can also narrow down by month to see which creatives are performing best during a certain month. And to identify which creatives are performing best, you can sort by cost per result. But keep in mind, the cost per result is based on the objective you chose. So make sure you're comparing apples to apples there. So next we're gonna talk about drilling down into the breakdown reports. This is in your ads manager area. We can click on campaign, ad set, or ad level, wherever we wanna see the different breakdowns. Click on the breakdown dropdown, and you can then select different segments to view. For example, you could choose breakdown by country, by age, by gender, by placement, and really see which segments are performing the best. For example, in some of these ad sets, certain age ranges, such as 35 to 44, performed much better than 45 to 54. So in that case, I might choose to set up a new test just targeting that age range to see if I can maximize that result. If you're running multiple placements, you may want to drill down by placements in this case to find out how they're doing. In some cases, it may help to break out the Instagram placement and the Facebook placement into their own ad sets. Another breakdown report you may want to look at is gender. That way you can see your cost per result for males versus females and decide if you want to split those into two different ad sets. So as promised, here's a great little hidden gem that a lot of people don't know about. It's the inspect button. It's only available when your ads are running and it's only at the ad set level. To get there, navigate to the ad set level, select the ad set, and choose Inspect. Now you'll see some charts on the right-hand side. The first chart is an overall view of your cost per result, and this will be helpful if you're looking at how your results are doing over time. If you see the cost per result going up over time, it may be time to turn that ad set off. The next chart you'll see is competition. This is a great graph to show you how many other advertisers might be bidding on similar or the same keywords as you are. If you see this graph going up, your cost per result may be going up as well, and it may be time to try some different targeting in that case. The next chart you'll see is audience saturation. This is basically a graph of your frequency, and it also shows you the first time impression ratio over time. As this goes up, it may be an indication of when it's time to refresh your creative and choose new images or new text. Auction overlap is the final graph you'll see, and this can help you see if you have too many ad sets that are using the same targeting and you're essentially bidding against yourself. If you see this going up, it may be time to use campaign budget optimization as your bid structure. If you want to dive deeper into reports, check out this video. And if you want to learn how to take these insights and scale bigger, watch this video.